Schools record their decisions about student achievement on the form R6. Making these decisions involves using all of the evidence in a student folio to determine a level of achievement in accordance with the syllabus requirements, and a finer-grained relative achievement decision in relation to the standards descriptors in the syllabus. In order for schools to make relative achievement decisions, they take into account all available evidence in a student folio and match it to the syllabus standards for each dimension. Relative achievement decisions are made by looking at the extent to which the standards have been achieved across the dimensions of the syllabus at, for example, a threshold, low, typical, or better than typical standard. Just as schools make decisions about achievement on a form R6 as VH 10, 5, 1, schools also make decisions about achievement in dimensions. Schools might choose to record these decisions in a number of ways, perhaps by using numbers, symbols, or letters to record each student's achievement in each dimension for each response. This video looks at on-balance judgments in dimensions and how these can be described and recorded using pluses and minuses. We are about to look at how a school might choose to record its judgment-making process for each dimension. A tick such as this represents a judgment for an objective for an assessment instrument. The position of the tick in the box does not represent fine-grained decision-making. It is recording a judgment that on balance matches the A descriptor for this objective, which is typically described. So, while the tick represents an on-balance judgment, there may be evidence of other qualities at standard B, for example, in the student response. For this activity, we are going to use the standards from the Health Education Senior Syllabus. In Health Education, there are four assessment instruments in a verification folio, and each instrument assesses each dimension and objective. So let's look at how schools might record their judgments in order to inform their relative achievement decisions. Let's start with this scenario. Before the school can make a relative achievement decision on the form R6, they need to make a decision about each dimension. Here, the school has recorded its judgments about each instrument by placing a tick on the exit standards for each objective. For Assessment 1, Assessment 2, Assessment 3, and Assessment 4. In this example, for Dimension 1, there is evidence in the folio matched with standards A, B, and on occasion, C. In Dimension 2, evidence has been matched with A and B descriptors, and in Dimension 3, with B and C descriptors. The school might award on balance an A. A. B. The folio, therefore, meets syllabus requirements for a very high achievement. While this folio is a very high achievement, the school might like to record finer-grained information to inform them in making a relative achievement decision. Schools might do this by allocating pluses or minuses to their decisions about dimensions. So in this case, in both dimensions 1 and 2, which have been judged on balance to be A, in order to represent and reflect the evidence matched to B and C descriptors, the school might choose to record this as A minus. In the third dimension, judged on balance to be a B, there is some evidence of C qualities, so the school has recorded their decision as a B minus. So an appropriate decision might be to place the folio at low, or towards the bottom of very high achievement. There may be a number of students with similar achievement. The school will make rung placement decisions for each student with similar achievement by looking at the extent to which the syllabus exit standards have been demonstrated for each dimension. In this example, the placement will be determined by considering the evidence of B and C standard qualities in the folio. Let's look at another scenario. The school has recorded its judgments about each instrument by placing a tick on the exit standards for each objective. For Assessment 1, Assessment 2, Assessment 3, and Assessment 4. In all three dimensions, evidence in the student folio has been matched to A standard descriptors, although not to A descriptors for every objective in every instrument. The school might choose to award on balance an A for each dimension. And the folio meets syllabus requirements for a VHA. Like the first example, this folio is also a very high achievement. However, the school might like to record finer-grained information to inform them in making a relative achievement decision. Schools might do this by allocating pluses or minuses to their decisions about dimensions. So in this case, while the school has found some qualities matched to B standard descriptors in dimensions 1 and 2, the school has judged each dimension to be on balance an A. In the third dimension, also judged on balance as an A, the school has found enough qualities at the B standard to record their decision as an A minus. So an appropriate decision might be to place the folio at the middle of, or typical, very high achievement. There may be a number of students with similar achievement. The school will make rung placements by looking at the extent to which the syllabus exit standards have been demonstrated for each dimension. In this example, placement will be determined by considering the evidence of B qualities in the folio. Let's look at another example. The school has recorded its judgments about each instrument by placing a tick on the exit standards for each objective. In all three dimensions, evidence in the student folio has been matched to A standard descriptors, although not for every objective in every instrument. For some objectives, an A might be recorded because there is a clear on-balance match to A descriptors, but there is some evidence in the response of B qualities. This matching of evidence to standards is what allows schools to make fine-grained decisions about student achievement. The school decides to award an A on balance for each dimension, and the folio meets syllabus requirements for a VHA. So an appropriate decision might be to place the folio at the middle of, or typical, very high achievement. The school will make a rung placement decision for each student with similar achievement by looking at the extent to which the syllabus exit standards have been demonstrated. Like scenario 2, which was also placed at typical VHA, the school has judged this folio to be typical. However, the school might place this folio higher than the previous one to reflect that it has fewer B qualities in the evidence. In this example, the student work has been matched on balance to the A standard descriptors for every objective, every time they have had an opportunity to do so. However, while the school has not recorded a B on balance for any objective, it is possible they have found some qualities in the student work matched to a B in relation to a descriptor or part of a descriptor. Another student's folio might include similar evidence, that is, the school has not recorded a B on balance for any objective, but in this case there are no qualities in the student work matched to a B in relation to a descriptor or part of a descriptor. This matching of evidence to standards is what allows schools to make fine-grained decisions about student achievement when they are presented with similar evidence. So the school is able to make appropriate rung placement decisions by taking into account the qualities of work they find in each folio. So for both examples, the folio is judged to be on balance A, 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 which meets syllabus requirements for a VHA. But the school might choose to record the decision about each dimension as A+. So an appropriate decision might be to place the folios at the top of very high achievement. The school might choose to place these folios on different rungs to reflect the differences they have identified in the evidence. Unlike the other standards, there is no standard above an A. So, the recording of the decision of a very high achievement might reflect slightly different thinking, but the principle is the same. Placement within this range will be dependent upon the extent to which the evidence in the folio matches on balance A standard descriptors, whether there are some qualities in the student work matched to a B in relation to a descriptor or part of a descriptor, or whether there are no qualities in the student work matched to a B in relation to a descriptor or part of a descriptor. This fine-grained decision-making by comparing evidence with standards allows schools to distinguish between achievement which might look similar on a criteria sheet but is different in the evidence. Schools make achievement decisions by matching evidence to standards. They will use the evidence in folios to make fine-grained decisions relative to the syllabus standards in order to inform placement on the form R6.